Welcome to the human computer interaction class. Okay, so already we have studied 3 units, and next one unit is 4th empirical research method in SCI, and already we have discussed in short about this empirical research. Now we will go in detail. So here is the first introduction to empirical research. Okay, and this is resources available on NPTEL site. Okay, so here is the objective. We learn about evaluation methods such as heuristic evaluation, cognitive walkthrough or cognitive models to evaluate designs at the early phases, and also interactive system design is not complete unless it is evaluated with end users. So we need end users, or the you can say end users like operator, or you can say last mile people. Okay, those are the stakeholders, those use those newly developed systems. So we shall learn about user evaluation methods. Okay, and we shall learn like the key concern in user evaluation, then data collection procedure and data analysis techniques. Okay, then empirical research is broadly defined as the observation-based investigation seeking to discover and interpret facts, theories or laws. Okay, simply observing or investigating the whole system, okay, to finding new discoveries or important facts, and modify the theories and develop new laws. Okay, so collection and analysis of end user data for determining usability of an interactive system is an observation based investigation, and hence it qualifies as empirical research. Okay, so there are themes of empirical research. Okay, generally there are three themes. Okay, in empirical research, first, answer and raise question about a new or existing UI design or interaction method, and second, observe and measure, and third, user studies. So research questions, it is very important in an empirical research to formulate appropriate research questions. Okay, already we know about the questions part. Okay, or here you can see some examples, some question. Okay, about a system, is it viable, useful, or it is good as or better than current practice? Or next, which of the several design alternative is best? Okay, we have to choose the best design. Then research questions are appropriate. Okay, should be appropriate for empirical research to formulate these questions. Okay, and here you can see some questions about a system. First, what are its performance limits and capabilities? So performance, what are its strengths and weaknesses? So it gives some pros and cons. Okay, and how much practice is required to become proficient? Okay, it is also related with performance. Okay, such questions are used, appropriate questions are used for empirical research. Then testable research questions. So while in above questions, while unquestionably relevant, are not testables. Okay, those are not relevant properly, are not testables, and we have to come up with testable questions in empirical research. We have to make new meaningful and relevant testable questions in system, for the system in empirical research. Okay, so testable research question, like here you can see an example. Suppose you have designed a new text entry techniques for mobile phones, and you think the design is good. In fact, you feel your method is better than the most widely used current technique, multi-tap, and you decide to undertake some empirical research to evaluate your invention and compare it with multi-tap. So what are your research questions? So according to this example, here are some questions, like weak question, like is the new technique better than multi-tap? Okay, it shows the goodness of that multi-tap technique. Okay, and better, is the new technique faster than multi-tap? So it's improves. It's these questions related to performance. Okay, and better still, is the new technique faster than multi-tap within 1 hour of use? So it gives more performance or more properties about the multi-tap. Okay, so testable questions even better we can generate, like here, if error rates are kept under 2%, is the new technique faster than multi-tap within 1 hour of use? So it's make a targeted or goal oriented performance for multi-tap techniques. Okay, and questions are testables because here is some data or a goal. Okay, and we can actually conduct experiments to test the answer to the questions related to multi-tap. And then testable research questions, we can ask very specific questions like last one, and relatively broad questions like the first one, which is weak. Okay, and for very specific question, the accuracy of the answer is high, whereas for broader question, the breadth or generalizability is high. Okay, so these are the graph for testable research questions. Okay, you can see here, and then internal and external validity. Okay, so extent to which the effect observed are due to the test condition is called internal validity of the research questions, and again the extent to which results are generalizable to the other people and other situation is known as the external validity of the research question. So here you can see both field, you can see validity effects are different. Okay, for internal validity, accuracy of the answer low to high, and then for external validity, width of the question narrow to broad. Okay, so there is the high accuracy questions, okay, for internal validity, and there are weak questions for external validity. Okay, for broader answer. And more examples on validity. So suppose you wish to compare two input devices for remote pointing at a projection screen, and external validity is improved if the test environment mimics expected uses. So the test environment should use a projection screen, position participant at a significant distance from screen, have participant stand, and include an audience. Okay, and more examples on validity that creates the test environment mimicking the real user scenario is not easy. It's like some simulation technique. Okay, but mimicking the actual environment. And instead, you can go for control experiment where you can ask the user to sit in front of a computer in a laboratory and use the pointing device to operate an application on the screen. So it is makes a real-time experiment-like situation. And above sitting setting can answer research question with high internal validity, okay, but can not help in determining if the answers are applicable in real world. Okay. Then more about more examples on validity. Consider another scenario where you wish to compare two text entry techniques for mobile devices. Okay, so to improve external validity, the test procedure should require participants to enter representative sample of text. Okay, and I have given an question related to this for KLM. Okay, in midterm. So to enter representative samples of text, like phrases containing letters, numbers, punctuations, and correct mistakes. And this may require compromising an internal validity. So you have to get more high quality questions for internal validity, and for external validity, you have for broader questions. Okay. So the trade-off is there is a tension between internal and external validity always. Okay. And the more the test environment and experimental procedure are relaxed to mimic real world situation, the more the experiment is susceptible to uncontrolled sources of variation such as pondering, distractions or secondary tasks. Okay, so already we have I have already given a video about this, okay, about this early internal and external validity and some testable research questions. Okay, now we will go to our next topic. Okay, implications. So first I will go to implication. Okay, so our next topic is implications. So there are good news, okay, always good news, and good news actually implies we do not need empirical research. Okay, but this is not the case. We have to go and study and analyze that system. So we just do a user study and ask participants which technique they preferred. Okay, because of the positive correlation, we need not take the pain in collecting and analyzing data. Okay, okay, so that's not make the good news, but we feel that it's a good news. Okay, because we have collecting and analyzing data. Okay, so here you can see this is not true. Okay, for as a good news. Okay, so if a participants ask which technique they prefer, they will probably give an answer, and even if they really have no particular preference, so they have no choice. Okay, and there are many reasons, such as how recently they were tested on a technique, personal interaction with the experimenters, etc. So they give answers, but not a particular preference. Okay, because they have to use that system. Okay, so therefore such preferences need not be indicative of the system performance. We need to scientifically ascertain the validity of the preference expressed by the participants, and which requires formulation of testable questions for internal and external validity. Okay, so with broader questions we may not get idea about the feasibility or usefulness of the system. Okay, and it is not enough to know if a system is better than another system only, but we also need to know how much better. Okay, and for example, it may not be feasible economically to develop a system that is only 5% better than the current system. We have to improve the system. Okay, so it is not always feasible. And for this, seeking feedback from users on broader question is not very helpful, because it not going to help the developer to design best design and develop new product. Okay, and it is a different view. Okay, also, so it is not very helpful from another perspective, and this it does not help to identify the strengths, weaknesses, limits, capabilities of the design, thereby making it difficult to identify opportunities for improvement. So broader questions will not help in design or develop new systems, but help to identify the user response, okay, and his activity related to that system. So such concerns can be addressed only with the raising of testable research questions, okay, feasible for experiment purpose. Okay, and an important point to note is, in order to test the validity of research question through observation, we need measurements. Okay, and this brings us to the second theme of empirical research, namely to observe and measure. Okay, so it makes a scientific analysis. Observe and measure makes scientific analysis to make testable question set. Okay, so in empirical research, observation is the most fundamental thing to do. Okay, and the observational empirical data can be gathered in two ways: manually, okay, first, and then experimentally, okay, or at automatic. Okay, so manual, in case of manual, a human observer manually records all the relevant observational data. Okay, and in second one, automatic, the observation can also be recorded automatically through the use of computer, software, sensors, cameras, and so on. Okay, and also used manually plus automatic, both. Okay, so observation is the most fundamental thing to do. Okay, and observational data can be gathered in two ways. Okay, and observation measurement is simply put a recorded observation. Okay, here is observation. Okay, observation is fundamental, but depends upon the manual and automatic way. And measurement, a recorded observation or a calculated observation. Okay, and there are broadly four scales of measurement that are used: first nominal, second ordinal, and third interval, and fourth ratio. Okay, so here is the scale of the measurement, like nominal. So we assign some codes to attributes of observational data, like here example, male is equal to 1 and female is equal to 2. Okay, so it's categorized the male and female. Okay, and then ordinal, in this scale of measurement the observations are ranked. Okay, giving some rank. Okay, so first, second, third. Okay, it's you can say the provide the ranking. Okay, ranking of the observations. Okay, then interval. An interval measurement, we consider equally spaced unit. Okay, but no absolute starting point. Like here you can see example of temperature 20, 30 and 40 centigrades. Okay, and the fourth ratio, this scale of measurement has an absolute starting point 0, and uses ratio of two quantities. Okay, so for example, already we have done related to this calculations, like 20 WPM and 30 CPS, etc. Okay, so it's make absolute results of the observation. Okay, so scale of measurement, you can see here nominal, ordinal, interval, ratio. So ratio measurement being the most sophisticated scale of measurement. Okay, it provides good information. Okay, and should be used as much as possible. Okay, so nominal is crude and ratio is sophisticated measurement. Okay, so in ratio measurement, already we have seen that ratio scales are the most preferred scale of measurement. Okay, and this is because ratio scales make it convenient to compare or summarize observations. Okay, and if you are conducting an empirical research, you should strive to report counts as ratios wherever possible. Okay, so here is the example. Assume you have observed that a 10 word phrase was entered by a participant in an empirical study in 30 seconds. So what should you measure? Okay, so we have some predefined data, like 10 words and 30 seconds. Okay, data is given with this example. Okay, so first, if you measure the time to enter text, means 30 seconds, t is equal to 30 seconds, as an indicator of the system performance, so it is a bad measurement. Okay, because we have to count the number of words, word phrase. Okay, so here, if you go for a ratio measurement, okay, so entry rate is equal to 10 divided by 0.5, okay, is equal to 20 WPM word per minute. So that is much better. Okay, because it gives some meaningful output. Okay, and gives a general indication of performance. Okay, so in above case, where t is equal to 30, it not provide the actual information related to the activity done by the observer. Okay, or participants. Okay, and in second one, it gives proper details about the activity. Okay, with some numerical measurement values, measuring values. Okay, so ratio measurement provides some more details. Okay, so sophisticated details. And another example here, suppose in an empirical study, you observed that a participant committed two errors while entering a 50 character phrase. Okay, so here is again, first, if you measure the number of errors committed, okay, n is equal to 2, as an indicator of system performance, it is a bad measurement, because we have to get the actual information. Okay, so in next you can see, if you go for a ratio measurement, here error rate is equal to 2/50. Okay, so result is 0.04, or you can say 4%. That is much better, and it is more general performance indicator. Okay, so it provide the best you can say performance details in best way. Okay, so that's all for this empirical research. Okay, in next video or lecture, I will provide the more details about empirical research. Okay, so that's for today's. That's for I will also give some intro about the next topic. Okay, so you can go and study about this introduction to empirical research second slide. Okay, so this provide the formulate, how to formulate the questions and how to process the observation and measurement. Okay, so sorry, already we have discussed this. Okay, and the objective is to learn about the other aspects of empirical research and about the design of various experiments. Okay, so thank you.